And I would like to begin by telling you a story about my experience with healing. I have healed myself with Chinese medicine, acupuncture, moxibustion, but there is a more subtle technique that I have experience with in healing myself. To help understand that technique, it's helpful for me to share a story from my childhood. My mother's relationship to medicine is an interesting one. She has the belief that mind can heal the physical sickness, pain, wounds, and so that had a big effect on me growing up. I was a healthy child growing up, but I was never given modern medicine. On one occasion in particular, my mother had a kind of miracle healing, some people would call. For her, it was just the experience of the absolute nature. So I was a toddler sitting in my high chair with a bowl of hot soup sitting in front of me. And I waved my arm and it knocked the soup onto my bare chest. Now, my mother says that I did not cry loudly and nor did I burn. So this kind of, your mind is kind of a mysterious thing. Another experience I have is growing up with my lower back. In high school, I injured my lower back. Again, in college, I hurt it again. And then during a trip to Qinghai, when I was practicing Midzong yoga, again, I injured my lower back. It was a L4, L5 herniated disc. And I visited the doctor in Xining, Qinghai, and he said that it was a very severe injury and that I should have surgery immediately. I didn't follow his prescription. Instead, I self-medicated myself. So when I injured my back practicing Midzong yoga in the mountains of Qinghai, my teacher immediately rolled up some wild herbs and singed my lower back, a kind of moxibustion. After that, wherever I went, I was always looking for acupuncture clinics, massage, sauna, trying to heal myself. But it wasn't until I met my Tai Chi teacher and studied Jianzhuang that I was able to really heal my L4, L5. Part of the problem was that I had an injury when I was in high school and then in college through sports, but also I was practicing lots of Vipassana meditation. And in Vipassana meditation, I was forcing my back straight in a way that that created too much strain. So I didn't know about the correct posture, and I didn't know about pulling my belly button to the spine. And so that created a lot of pressure on my lower back.
在青海山上练习瑜伽的时候，我的腰椎受损之后，我的老师当时在山上采了一些中药材，然后当即把这些药材敷到我的后背上，但是当时呢疗法并不是特别好，所以说之后我一直在寻找其他一些疗法，比如说像针灸治疗、按摩推拿以及桑拿，但是呢疗程都不是特别好，直到在1997年。 我就非常荣幸地见到了我的第一位教我站桩的太极老师。其实站桩是整个纠正了我的站姿，正确的站姿它其实治愈了我的整个腰椎。那大家都知道，这个我当时呢就是练习站桩的时候，这个姿势并不是很正确，我的是后腰是整个凸起的，所以说整个腰部它并不是在一条轴线上的。那这样的话，错误的姿势呢会让我整个身体的压力都全压在我的颈椎上。
So let's try some meditation for a couple of minutes. We sit.
所以说这个姿势非常重要。下面我想就是吴光老师教大家如何来打坐。
So I just want to give you the feeling of how it is to sit properly in a meditation posture.
教大家一些正确的打坐的方式姿势。
We should be straight.
首先大家要坐直，双手放在两膝上。
Relaxed but with strength.
要完全放松。
Slightly pull the belly button to the spine.
微收小腹.
Chin gets tucked in slightly.
下颚是收起的, 微微.
Not like this.
不要过度的.
Softly in. As if we're wearing a gold crown.
头顶的百会穴要面朝, 天空. 整个身体是直的。
Tip of the tongue touches behind the front teeth.
舌头要尝试抵着上颚。
Breathe through the nose and into the lower dantian, four fingers beneath the belly button.
去感受整个呼吸和气息在自己的身体中流转。
And gently close our eyes.
最后轻轻地闭上我们的双眼。
We stay still like this for 3 to 5 minutes. Breathing in through the nose into the dantian, sitting with lightness and strength.
我们可以这样静静地待上3到5分钟，去静静地感受我们身体中的能量。
Allow our mind to calm down.
让自己的心完全放松下来。
Okay, that's great. Thank you very much. So even if we have a short moment of quiet heart, quiet mind, it's a very important. Important for the mental health and physical health. So this is something that I feel very strongly about, and I wish I could speak to you directly in Chinese, but luckily we have a wonderful translator here. So, but this quiet feeling is very important, especially if we want to play Tai Chi Chuan. As Tai Chi Chuan is born from Wuji and is the source of yin and yang, there should be no intention or movement as we begin our Tai Chi Chuan practice. This condition reflects the original Wuji state. When we attack and we start to react, we enter the Tai Chi state in which yin and yang are generated according to our opponent's movements. Because all skills follow the yin-yang principle, it is sometimes said that Tai Chi Chuan derives from the change, conversion, and development of yin and yang.
俗话说无极而太极，所以说太极其实就有一阴一阳之道。那当我们在练习太极拳的时候，一定不要谨小慎微、瞻前顾后，一定要做到完全的放松，要进入到一种完全无极的状态。那太极呢，就是当我们的身体达到这种阴阳平衡的时候，在重心很稳的时候，我们的身体会以不变应万变。所以说，当我们在练功的时候， 哪怕外界有这种物质在侵害自身体的时候，我们的身体会有这种防御机制。这也是为什么我一直想强调这个阴阳的平衡对于自身健康的重要性。During
my adult life, I have mostly been living according to this principle, yun you si hai. And this wandering according to a commitment and love for the flow is essential to my experience of Tai Chi. Also, on three occasions, I had the good fortune to enter into a heiguan, which is a dark retreat. So on three separate occasions, the first time for 1 week, second time for 3 weeks, and the third time for 13 days, I lived in total darkness. A friend brought me food, and the house was sealed in such a way that light was never allowed to enter for 24 hours a day. And for, well, the longest was 3 weeks. In that kind of darkness, in that kind of retreat, then I was able to enter into the integration of yin and yang. So this is known as keeping the center.
那我之前呢，在练习这种太极拳的时候，还有之前的经历，我有过三周的这种闭关进修。那第一次呢是一周，然后之后会坚持了三周。那在当时呢，我是在闭关的期间，我是真正的感觉到了我的身体是达到了阴阳的平衡。那这个点呢，在太极拳中叫做这个中极。From
that center, from this quiet, still center, where the yin and yang are in integration, there will come a sound. It could be light, but I would like to offer you some sound from the chiba.
那下面的吴光老师会为大家演奏一下尺八，它其实可以感，大家仔细听可以感受到这种阴阳平衡的这种能量，其实从这个尺八中可以体现出来。 那尺八呢，是我们中是 是我们中国的国宝，在一千多年前呢，是由中国唐代，然后传入到日本中去的。
Tai Chi Chuan is based on the Tai Chi principle that expresses an ancient view of the universe. Tai means great or immense. Ji means extreme or limit. Traditionally speaking, Tai Chi is the same as Dao because both refer to the basic, all-encompassing natural law of the universe. In order for things to prosper or function well, they must be in harmony with Tao. Through the practice of Tai Chi Chuan, we evolve our natural potential to be in a flow with Tao and enjoy good physical health and mental well-being.
Tai Chi and Tai Chi Chuan actually represent the whole universe. That Tai Chi, Tai, is the big, and Chi is the end. 那太极呢，其实就是一个道家哲学，诠释的就是道生一，一生二，二生三，三生万物的一个过程。
To practice Tai Chi Chuan correctly, we should contemplate the idea of Wuji. Wuji is the primordial nature of the cosmos. In our deepest state of existence, primordial nature erupts like a vibrant volcano of light, transparent designs, and rainbow color. According to the Tai Chi concept, the world started from Wuji, a state of nothingness or non-being. It is like a homogeneous mixture of all things, sometimes likened to a cloud. Wuji describes the universe in its most primal form, before there was any differentiation of matter. When the universe began to emerge from the Wuji state, Yin Qi and Yang Qi were created and became differentiated. The Yang Qi, which was light in weight, rose up to form the sky, and the Yin Qi, which was heavy, sank down to form the earth. Within the differentiation of yin and yang, all the life of the universe started. Tai Chi's state is the source of all things, so sometimes Tai Chi is called the mother of all things.
下面呢，我主要来讲一下无极与太极的区别。无极呢，是一个宇宙最初始的一个状态，天下初开，一切皆为混沌时是无极，而无极是完全是没有极限、没有变化、无生无灭、完全静止的一个状态。而太极是在宇宙大爆炸之后，然后是阴阳两气生成万物，而这一个变化过程叫太极。 那刚才我们说到阴阳两气，那阳是为热、为化、为气化，然后渐渐形成了大气和天空，而阴是为暗、为聚、为大地，所以说这是具体化。这也是为什么我们刚才一直提到这个阴阳平衡对于练习太极拳的一个重要之点。Actually,
Tai Chi is the yin and yang. It is the union of twirling, spiraling, and harmonious twisting of opposites, heaven and earth, man and woman, self and other, left brain and right brain. The play, tension, harmony, dance, bleeding, blending and separation of yin-yang opposites is Tai Chi. In traditional Chinese medicine, yin and yang are zhangfu. What is the benefit we can get if we balance Tai Qi through yin and yang, we can enjoy good physical health and mental well-being.
太极其实就是一阴一阳之道，我们所熟知的天与地，寒与暑，日与夜，男与女，男与女，个人与他人，包括左脑与右脑，都是太极的范畴。那这一点它又是与中医领域是相辅相成的，在中医里呢是五脏，它为 为阴，然后六腑为阳，所以说了解太极，了解这个阴阳对我们有什么益处呢？能够很大程度上的提高我们的身心健康。
So, Vivian, do we go to 2:30? Should I go to 2:30 or do we have a little bit longer?
It's okay.
Okay. So through my experiences in Heiguan, I understood how to integrate Tai Chi more with aspects of my life. So I would like to speak about Tai Chi in daily life a little bit. For example, my I Ching divinations became more accurate after finding how to integrate yin and yang. My writings got more rigorous and capacity for thinking more detailed. My ink paintings evolved. Business developments progressed, and I became more sensitive to playing the chirpa. For successful practice of Tai Chi Chuan, we must understand how yin and yang permeate everything. Then we can integrate many traditional and modern techniques into our daily lives. So today I would like to share about two traditional ways that the principles of Tai Chi can be integrated with our daily lives. First is through playing the chiba, and second is by practicing Tai Chi Chuan. Chiba helps us tremendously in learning how to train our breath. When we play the chiba, we must utilize the energy in our lower dantian. By training our lower dantian, there will be many health benefits as well as mental benefits. We can play the chiba in union as well with others and make beautiful music.
今天我主要来讲一下生活中与太极相紧密联系的两个事物，一个就是尺八，另外一个就是太极拳。当我们练习吹奏尺八的时候，我们训练的其实我们的气息。那我们在吹奏这个乐器的时候，我们通常会使用我们的丹田，那这种能量是能够促进我们的身心健康。
And for the practice of Tai Chi Chuan, I would like to share the first of 24 Yang style movements. Generally, Tai Chi Chuan is said to belong to the Neigong practice, and